evening, Amuseaholics, and today we're at Dr. Frights Halloween Night. Horror World. Spooky.
Yeah, really excited for this one.
Yeah, it's our first time here at Dr. Frights, so we're looking forward to checking out the horror mazes. There's loads of, it's all under a marquees, isn't it? So there's bars and food outlets, various other things here. So yeah.
Great if it's raining, so.
Yeah, it's true, it's a good idea, because at least if the weather's rubbish, you're still undercover, whereas a lot of events are big areas outdoors, so it is a good idea actually, having it under marquees. Also means you can't see what's going on until you get inside. Mm. So yeah, we're just coming now, so we'll say quick hello to a couple of our friends here, look. Looked like he's had better days, to be honest.
He was clowning around, but he's not anymore.
Yeah, yeah, not clowning around anymore, is he? Lost his head. Well, we're going to head round now, and we're not going to be filming inside the mazes themselves. However, we'll let you know what we thought of each one as we come out.
Yeah, purely because we don't want to spoil the experience for anybody. That's right.
Yeah, we think it's best if you discover it for yourself. We'll film a bit of the atmosphere, show you what's here, and let you know what we thought.
Yep.
So, we're into the entrance of Dr. Frights Horror World, the Halloween nights. So it looks like the majority of the events undercover in marquee, so we'll get in and have a look around. Over on the left we've got Simply Sicily, where you can get a variety of coffees and hot cocktails. You can add a shot of booze to your coffee, spice it up a bit. Got a dark alley. Woo. There's been photo opportunities here. Creepy heads. A Horror World mask collection. Oh, they are pretty horrible. Hey Jason, how's it going? Lots of great photo opportunities here. So we're heading into our first maze of the evening, Monsters and Madmen. Monsters and Madmen Museum.
Oh, I'll tell you what, it was so good. Honestly, really good.
Yeah, I was at the back of the group. They only let the four of us. We're in a group of four. We've got two friends with us. And they only let our four in, didn't they, as
a
group?
Yeah, it seems like they were letting groups in. So if you was a group of two, they let you in with twos. You know, group of eight, they let you in with eight of you, you know.
Yeah, I think that was good, actually.
That was really good, actually.
Yeah, it was really impressed with that. So.
We did queue a bit longer as a result, but you don't mind, do you, when you slide, when it's a good experience?
No, that's right, I think it's worth it for the experience. I think it was really good, actually. Yeah. We were really surprised.
Yeah, really, really good.
I mean, I suppose we didn't know what to expect, really. But yeah, that was a great experience, really enjoyed it.
I really did like the use of the strobe effects in the mazes. Really like that.
Yeah, I think what I realised actually was a lot of the costumes that the actual actors used, there was a lot of dummies wearing the same costumes.
Yeah, a lot.
And they were everywhere, so you're like, you don't know who's real and who's not. So yeah, actually, it was very effective. The actors were giving it their all as well. It had quite a rough feel to it, the decor and that sort of thing, but it was still really well done. So what do you reckon, your pumpkin rating for that one?
I mean, that's the first maze of the night, so I mean, you know.
Oh yeah.
But, I mean, for me, I actually screamed quite a few times in it, and I don't do that. So for me, that's pretty terrifying, really.
So four pumpkins, five pumpkins.
I wouldn't want to go five because I haven't done the other mazes yet, but I'd say four and a half. Maybe.
I'm gonna give that one a four. I enjoyed it, even at the back.
I really, really enjoyed it, you know. So. It's one of the best mazes I've done personally, to be honest.
Yeah.
I really, really enjoyed it.
It comes, the most
I can't say
thing,
it enough.
Most important thing is it came together really well, didn't
it?
So.
It did. And I mean, like the different sections as well.
Yeah, lots of different, lots of variety. It was kind of one theme, but because it was Monsters and Madmen, there were lots of different Monsters and Madmen. So yeah, it came together really nice.
Yeah, no, it was really interesting.
So she saw us over by the Horror World Fantasy Theatre. We've got the murderous Merlin's torture show. And he's very happy about that head he seems to have acquired. Now we're over to our next maze of the evening, Grindhouse in Wonderland.
In Wonderland.
Yeah, the theme in there is really cool actually.
Yeah, it was quite a unique concept. I actually think what let it down the most was the music. Like, they were playing like metal or heavy or sort of rock Disney tunes.
I actually like that part.
I enjoyed the music, but it made me feel good, not scared. So it's one of those really. I mean, it was an enjoyable experience, but in terms of a horror maze, I'm not sure if it quite fit.
I was at the front of our group this time, and I did get a couple of jump scares, but not as many as I would have liked, you know?
Yeah, you'd have expected a few more being at the front, really, wouldn't you?
But I think part of the problem was we did catch up with another group, and a lot of the actors were terrorising this one person out of this group,
yeah.
And she was terrified, so they were focused on her, and we caught up with them, so they wasn't focused on us, really, so that was a bit disappointing.
Yeah, spoiler alert, there's chainsaws in there, and she clearly had a phobia of chainsaws because she was getting terrorised, backed into corners.
Yeah.
And so we had to wait for her at one point because it's like, oh, we're not going to get any attention if we carry on now. So that was a bit of a shame. I mean, you know, it was a good experience, but I didn't feel like that one was as good as the first one.
No. I'd say it was probably about scare factor, really. I'd say 2.5 pumpkins, really.
Yeah, well, I'm going to try and stick to whole pumpkins, so I'm going to go with 3. I'll round it up to 3. But it's a very generous 3, whereas the last maze was a high 4.
Yeah. I mean, even though I did really enjoy it, though. I really enjoyed looking at the theme and things like that, you know, and the characters. Like,
oh, yeah, the experience was still good. I didn't feel like that one was quite as long either. It didn't feel quite as long.
It didn't feel as long,
no. Maybe just the layout, I don't know. But they're both decent mazes, but all in all, that one wasn't as good as the first one.
No, it wasn't as good. I still enjoyed it.
Still good, yeah.
The next maze of the evening is the Killer Clowns of the Caribbean. Looking good.
Looking good, yeah. Great.
Got a Killer Clown Hall of Fame. Jumbo. Twisty. Spaulding. Good old Pennywise. And who should forget? So we've just escaped the Killer Clowns of the Caribbean.
Really cool, isn't it? Really well themed.
Yeah, and so I did like the sets and so on, and the clowns are quite cool. Pirate clowns is a bit of a weird concept though.
Yeah, not really scary in my eyes, but
yeah, but personally I don't find clowns that scary anyway, so obviously I know some people are scared of clowns. One of our friends with us is actually not very fond of clowns. But she was having a good run around, wasn't she?
Yeah, she was. But they did have really cool, like a laser effect in there, and I've never seen anything like that before.
Yeah,
I think that was a really cool concept.
Yeah, it was smoke, wasn't it? There was smoke, and then lasers shot sort of a few feet in the air, like horizontally.
Yeah,
and it basically meant you couldn't see below the smoke. So basically, the clowns are just crawling around underneath. So that was really cool.
It was really cool.
So yeah, and there was also some motion-activated cannons, wasn't there?
Yeah.
So yeah, it was a good maze. Again, I think scare factor for me, only 3 out of 5.
Yeah,
well,
I'd say 3. I think the Grindhouse one was a bit more than the Pirates one. I did really like the theming and the music as well, and the narration as well.
Yeah, I would agree. So it was a good experience, but I think that's the least scary that we've done out of all of them so far.
So now we're entering our final maze of the evening, the House of Wax.
Of Wax sure was creepy.
That was really creepy.
It was my turn to go to the front of the group, and I must have had 6 or 7 serious scares. Yeah. I was really, really impressed with that one.
The atmosphere was fantastic in there.
Yeah.
Really good.
I think I've got to hand a little bit of credit to the fact that I was at the front, but I would say that was, for me, that was the scariest one. I wouldn't quite give it a 5. But I think definitely a solid 4 out of 5 pumpkins for that.
Yeah,
one.
I think that was a 4 pumpkin one for me. I did enjoy the Mad Men one, Monsters and Mad Men.
Yeah.
More than that one personally. I did get a lot of scares in that one.
I think to be fair that I was obviously at the front of that one. I think that played a big part of it. But I got plenty of scares. The atmosphere was dead creepy. There was strobe lighting. There was lots and lots of sort of mannequins and
decoys.
Models and decoys. So again, you never knew which were real.
Yeah.
And they were hiding behind them, hiding next to them. There was like two mannequins, and then the one in the middle was a real person, and they looked the same. So that was really good. There was a bit of grabbing in that one as well.
Yeah.
If you go around and grabbing your legs and that sort of thing.
Yeah,
when
no, I really, really did enjoy that. I've got a few scares myself in that one.
Yeah.
It was really, really cool.
I felt like that was the creepiest one because the obviously the Monsters and Mad Men was great, but you recognised all the characters.
Yeah.
And that familiarity to me took a little bit away from the actual scare factor. Enjoyment factor, by all means, it was really, really good.
Yeah.
But I think for actually scares, I think the House of Wax took it for me.
Yeah.
I appreciate you. Obviously, you got quite a lot of good scares in the Monsters and Mad Men as well. So, yeah, they're both. I think those two are the clear top two, aren't they?
They are.
Monsters and Mad Men and the House of Wax are the clear top two. Over on the left-hand side when you come in. Obviously, the Killer Clowns and the Grindhouse, they were both solid mages as well.
I think it all depends on what you're scared of, really. Like, some people are really scared of chainsaws and things like that. Other people are scared of clowns, you know. That's why it wasn't so scary for us in that
perspective. That's it, you can't knock them for the variety, can you?
No.
So, yeah, House of Wax, for me, top maze. Certainly that one, and Monsters and Mad Men, the top two.
Just a tip as well is that the maze queues actually close at 10 o'clock. So you need to make sure that you're in the mazes before that time.
Yeah, make sure you're in the queue before 10 o'clock. The event actually runs from 7 p.m. until 10:30 p.m. But the maze queues are closed at 10 o'clock. So just make sure you're in the queue by then for all your mazes.
But now, overall,
the atmosphere of
those wax was fantastic.
Yeah, really creepy, really creepy.
So over by the merch stand, there's some Dr. Frights t-shirts. Also some stickers, key rings, Dr. Frights' very own hot sauce, good old hats, and an alternative t-shirt design with a creepy clown.
Well, we've now completed all the scare mazes.
Yeah, what an evening.
Yeah, it's been really, really good actually. I didn't know what to expect really, but I've been pleasantly surprised. Really, really good, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's been really, really cool. We've had a really good lot of scares, really.
Yeah, I got at least one scare in every maze. The most for me was the House of Wax, and that was a fantastic maze. I really like they've been bold, and they've tried to create something a bit different.
Yeah.
There's lots and lots of clever techniques employed in those mazes that you don't see in the likes of Alton Towers and that sort of thing. I mean, Alton Towers Scare Fest mazes, the quality of the sets was really high. whereas the sets here are a little bit more thrown together and rough around the edges. That almost adds to it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's interesting because it's all undercover and you're in a marquee, but once you're in the main, you don't feel like you're indoors. It just genuinely feels like you could be outside.
Well, it could be anywhere. It's quite dark, isn't it?
It doesn't affect the atmosphere at all.
No, it's quite dark, isn't it, really? So, yeah, it's been really, really good, though.
Yeah, really good time. Really, really good. Definitely want to come back again next year.
Yeah, we had a bit of food from the Grind Grill, didn't we, as well?
Yeah.
That was quite nice. I think it's a shame it's only the only place you can really get proper food from here.
Yeah.
But still enjoyable. We had a burger each, didn't we?
Yeah,
and it was
nice.
Really tasty, really nice. Not too badly priced, I suppose. Pretty typical for these sort of places. It can be a little bit expensive, but it wasn't too bad. I think it was around sort of £15 for the two burgers, something like that. So not too bad, but you know, sort of premium prices. Wasn't absolutely over the top because it was a nice large burger and a selection of sauces and all that sort of thing for you to enjoy as well, including their very own hot sauce. So that's worth a go as well. But overall, pretty decent event. It's not massive in here.
But I like that. I like that it's not massive. You're not walking around loads of places.
Yeah, everything's. The edges of the mazes are all quite close together, so in that sense, it's well designed. The mazes kind of take you around in a circle, so you aren't left walking for ages to get to the mazes or to walk back, are you? So, yeah, I think Dr. Frodo's is definitely another one for us to come back to another year because it's been good fun.
Yeah, definitely. We had a really good time here.
Yeah.
Really enjoyed it. We didn't queue that long for the mazes, particularly.
No, not really. I think the longest queue was maybe somewhere between 15 and 20 minutes. And that was for Monsters and Madmen right at the start of the evening when it was at its busiest. So I don't think it was that bad at all, really.
No, it is a Wednesday night.
Yeah, so it might be busier at the weekend, but today not bad at all.
No, we had a really good time.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you enjoyed this video, please remember to like and subscribe. It means a lot to us. And until next time, we hope you get out and explore amusement parks and more. See you next time.
Soon.